Let's begin our third panel for the day. After delving deep into the technology and impact of sustainable energy access for livelihoods, it's time to look at the role of clean energy enterprises in creating these impacts. To set the context, we would like to call upon a duo, an end user, a dairy entrepreneur who was in the need of a solution and a solution provider who was able to provide the needed solution. Let us welcome Thippeswammy, a dairy entrepreneur who decided to return to his roots and take up farming. Today, his dairy farm has expanded thanks to the right technology intervention of the solar-powered milking machine and market access. On the other hand, we have Manjunath Bhagwat, Senior Manager, SELCO Solar Light Private Limited, who has been instrumental in SELCO's efforts to carry out last-mile energy interventions. With over 15 years of experience in managing business operations, he understands the nuances of last-mile energy access implementation. Please welcome Thippeswammy and Manjunath.
ನಾವು ಈ ಸೋಲಾರ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಮಿಷನ್ ಹಾಕ್ಸಿದ್ವಿ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ 2007-2008 ನಾವು ಮನೆಗೆ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ಗೋಸ್ಕರ ನಮ್ಮ ತಮ್ಮರು ತಂಗಿ ವರ್ಕರಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾಗ ಕರೆಂಟಿನ ಬಾರಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಊರಲ್ಲಿ. ಆದ ಕಾರಣ 4 ಲೈಟ್ ಹಾಕ್ಸಿದ್ವಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಗ್ರಾಮೀಣ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಲ್ಲಿ ಲೋನ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸಿತಾಪುರ ಗ್ರಾಮೀಣ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್.
His name is Thippeswammy from a very rural place near Chitradurga district, Karnataka. So his first intervention with solar was through solar lights, because he has siblings who were studying and there was no electricity in their village. So solar lights were implemented through a loan from a Grameena bank in Karnataka.
ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇವ್ರದ್ದು ಸೆಲ್ಕೊ ಸೋಲಾರ್ ನಮಗೆ ಪರಿಚಯ ಆಯ್ತು. ಈಗ ರೀಸೆಂಟಲ್ಲಿ 2 ವರ್ಷದ ಹಿಂದ್ಗಡೆ 2 ಹಸು ತಾಂಡಿವಿ ನಾವು. ಹಸು ತಾಂಡು ಊರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಕಣೆ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ, ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ಡೈರಿ ಫಾರಮು ತೋಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ತೋಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಲಿನ ಕೂಲಿ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಹಾಲು ಕರೆಯೋದು, ಸಂಜೆ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ಹಸು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಭಾರಿ ತುಂಬ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕರೆಯೋದು ಅದೆಲ್ಲ. ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಮಿಲ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಮಿಷಿನ್ ಹಾಕ್ಸ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಇದು ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಆಯಿತು, ಸೋಲಾರ್ದು 64,000 ಆಯಿತು. ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿಗೆ ಇದು ಹಾಕ್ಸಿದ್ರೆ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಆದರೆ ತೋಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಇರಲ್ಲ.
So he went back to his village and bought 2 cows. He wanted to start a dairy farm. And one of the biggest problems in rural locations in India is the labor problem, because of the increase in the rate of migration towards the cities, there are no labors for anything. So the same problem was faced with Thippeswammy as well. He wanted to start a dairy farm, but there were no people to help him for the dairy farm. That's why the solar, the milking machine, I'm just talking about milking machine as an instrument, which was able to help him. But then when the solar intervention was actually introduced to him, he thought it was financially expensive. But the need was there. There was no electricity at all in his village. So the solar machine was, solar was the solution for them.
ಸೊ ಇದು ಹಸು ಹಾಲು ಕರೆಯೋದು ನಾವು ಬೆಳಗ್ಗಿಂದ 6-7, ಸಂಜೆ 6-7. ಅವಾಗ ನಮಗೆ 3 ಫೇಸ್ ಕರೆಂಟು 3 ಗಂಟೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಕೊಡೋದು. ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಇದು ಸೋಲಾರ್ ಮಿಷಿನ್ನು ಮುಖ್ಯನಾಥ್ ಸರ್ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಹಾಕ್ಸ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೆ ನಾವು ಮಿಲ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಮಿಷಿನ್ ಹಾಕ್ಸ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಈಗ ಲೇಬರ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, 2 ಹಸು ಕಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಫಸ್ಟು, ಈಗ 10 ಹಸುಗೆ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಅದನ್ನು.
ಓಕೆ, ಒನ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡೈರಿ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಯು ಕಾಂಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಅ ಕೌ ವೆನೆವರ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿ ಐದರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ 6-7 ಆಸ್ ಹಿ ಸೆಡ್, ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ 6-7. If there is no power at that time, he cannot use the milking machine. So he wanted reliability of all the things, and that was the priority. So he took the solution of milking, solar power milking machine. As I told, he started with 2 cows. Now the market, the production increased, the market linkage happened, and now he owns 10 cows. So the dairy, little dairy farm has actually become a kind of big dairy farm now.
ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಎರಡರಿಂದ ಮೂರು ಜನ ಲೇಬರ್ ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಹತ್ತು ಹಸು ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳಕ್ಕೆ. ಈಗ ಸಮಯನೂ ಉಳಿತಾಯ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಒಬ್ಬನೇ ಲೇಬರ್ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾನೆ, ಒಂದು ಗಂಟೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹಾಲು ಕರಿಯೋದು ಎಲ್ಲ
ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ
ಮುಂದಿನ ದಿನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಡಬಲ್ ಕ್ಲಸ್ಟರ್ ಮಿಷಿನ್ ಹಾಕ್ಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಇನ್ನೂ ಹತ್ತು ಹಸು ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಆದಾಯನೂ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗಿದೆ ನಮಗೆ.
So he's hoping he'll have 10 more cows very soon so that his farm will be doubled.
Hello everyone, I'm Manjunath Bhagwat. As enterprises last from 2 years, SELCO installed so many livelihood systems. Nearly in my region, actually around 600 livelihood solutions we given in the Chittadurga region. Actually, as Thippeswammy told, he is our existing customer, last 10 years old customer, Thippeswammy. Last 10 years back, we installed solar lightings. Then, in that time, they don't have cows. So later, he started dairy business. Then he faced some problems like power cut issues and like labor issues. So then he came to us and we take as a challenge, as Kusumadara sir also there. Because of power cut issue and labor problem, we provided a solar milking machine. So then he actually increased his business also. It's very good to us.
Iga current in problem illange iga nadita idu 2 varshakke ondu sarinu samasya bandilla matte adu nodibitti iga job cutter adru solar da job cutter aagbekanta thirmana maadtene.
So it's telling, I mean, this is a very interesting fact, how one livelihood intervention leads to another one. Now, in last 2 years, since the intervention of solar pond milking machine, he hasn't had any problem. So that's when the trust built. Now he's looking for solar pond shaft cutter, which is a very big requirement in those regions because that goes as a feed for the cows. And so that's why he's saying, I'll be looking forward to have another livelihood intervention in the form of solar pond shaft cutter.
And also, yeah, actually, we actually connecting through solar energy other applications like milking machine and roti rolling machine, printer Xerox, and sewing machine, blower. So all those, this problem identification is very important. During the site survey, actually, if you don't go to village, then you don't get any problems. Once you enter the villages, then you get the issues. If issues came, then we will take it as a challenge. So then we will give the solution. So all the products came like this only. So main thing is to scale up these products, financial linkage is very important. So we tie up with microfinance and rural Grameen banks and all other banks. So along with that support, we did so many livelihood interactions.
Thank you, sir. So that's the relationship between the enterprise and the entrepreneur.
Next, we have Prerna Sharma, Policy Associate at Clean Energy Access Network, an All India representative organization launched in 2014 to support, unify, and grow the decentralized clean energy sector in India. Please welcome Prerna.
Good evening, everyone. I am Prerna from Clean Energy Access Network. I am here to set the context for the panel to discuss role of clean energy enterprises in scaling sustainable livelihoods. So, as you all may know, that Clean is a member-based network of organizations who are working in decentralized renewable energy in India, And apart from, right from providing basic lighting to clean cooking till delivering last mile product and services, our members are actively involved in providing innovative technological solution, facilitating access to finance, capacity building, and providing market linkages. So these became the thematic area of clean, where clean works on these area and facilitate our members on that. So coming to role of clean energy enterprises in scaling sustainable livelihood, first we need to understand what is a last mile enterprise. It is a small entrepreneur which is working at a village or block level to provide products and services to the end user. So to create or to develop a last mile entrepreneurs, clean energy enterprises now has to play a various role. Apart from only providing energy, they have to play various roles so that they can complete the chain. So they provide electricity and energy for lighting and for operating their productive appliances. They also provide DRE based technology solution. Very few members also support in providing finances to the last mile enterprises. The main thing which our members do is capacity building of the last mile to create last mile enterprises, especially to women, so that they can get involved in livelihood activities and thus empowering them. There are many business models, but few business models. The main business model which our members are taking is they are providing DRE based technology solution and skilling them to operate that solution. And they are also providing, they are also skilling the enterprises, and they are providing market linkages, and they are also facilitating them to distribute their end products in the market. So a few of the challenges I am stating here. The main challenge which our energy enterprises are facing is the access to finance for the end users. Here in case last mile entrepreneurs. So it is a very small size of loan. So very few financial institution and organization are taking care of that, and thus it is creating an impact of to making last mile energy enterprises. And there is a demand and supply mismatch of energy. If an enterprise has mapped some kind of demand, then at the end of the day, when the delivery time comes, the demand is not fully consumed. Some portions are left unmet. And the lack of skilled manpower to provide the technical assistance and also to support in skilling of those last mile entrepreneurs. With this, I would like to open the panel.
We have the panelists on stage. At first, we have Joysing Teron, who's from the hills of Kabi Anglong and is the founder of Hills Solar Power. He has successfully introduced solar powered livelihood solutions to the remotest village of Kabi Anglong, a region with some of the most vulnerable populations and inaccessible hamlets in the country. A systems thinker and a last mile innovator, Joysing has implemented solar solutions across his region and has set models for the region. And please welcome Joyce. And next we have Sudeshna Mukherjee, who is the Deputy Country Director of MLinda. He oversees partnerships, field operations, capacity building, community engagement, and impact assessment at MLinda. Also, Sudeshna's skills in community engagement cement MLinda's strong connections with mini-grid users. Please welcome Sudeshna. Next, we have KS Patil, who's the branch manager of Bailahangal branch of SELCO Solar, one of the challenging regions of the state. Under his leadership, the branch has been able to intervene some of the toughest conditions and created impactful energy access delivery models. Please welcome case party. Next, we have Upendra Sahoo, who is a solar entrepreneur with 20 years of entrepreneurial experience. He is the founder and managing director of Tarini Enterprises, a social enterprise that aims to provide solutions to basic energy access issues in the Mayurbhanj district of Odisha. Please welcome Upendra Sahoo. Now, we'd like to call upon Ekta Jaju, founder and CEO of ONganic Foods, who is extremely passionate about organic farming and its impact on smallholder farmers in East India. Ekta has strong experience in the areas of sustainable energy and agriculture and consulted to several national and international organizations, including UN Women, GIZ, and other organizations. Please welcome Ekta. Finally, to moderate the event, I'd like to welcome Sarah Alexander from SELCO Foundation, who will continue the discussion, and also Anupati to support the panel.
The earlier discussions today, the end user, or whether it's the technology developers, what we'd like to get down today is actually speaking to each of them and sort of hearing their stories, you know, of the regions that they come from, their models, and how they've been able to crack actually delivering these livelihood services at the last mile to the customer. So we have about five enterprises sitting here from very different terrains, and hopefully through this discussion we'll be able to learn more about the regions they're from and the models that they have engaged in to deliver these last mile services. So I'll begin with Joysing, who's from Assam. He actually started in 2007. You know, sort of delivering or fixing with contracts to after sales service and maintenance for systems. That was his main revenue model. And then in 2015, he started selling solar home lighting systems as well as livelihood systems. I think he did about 350, so 160 home lighting systems and about 25 livelihood systems. So I've asked him to speak today, sir, about Assam. Many people here have not traveled to Assam, so it is a very difficult region, and maybe you can speak to what that region, basically your model, what that region is like, and what are the challenges you have faced in actually implementing some of these livelihood solutions.
Question. So exactly, I got in touch in solar with IRA since 2007. That time I got only installation, which is supplied by the government of Assam. That time I got only the daily wages. That time, then after that, I do for servicing also. Then after that, when I do servicing for 2-3 years, then the DIA has called me to linkage with the SELCO India. Then I came for training. SELCO has called me a training here at Bangalore. Then I went back to my place, that is Kargiano. That is the most interior place in the country, according to me. Because I have never found this type of place in Assam and in so many places. So if I compare to other place, then my place is the worst. Then I do this business. So when I went back to my place, then I start my business on 2015, 25 of May. Then I refused how to do my business at that time, because I cannot sell the product. All the products, all the solar system has given to the villagers by the government free of cost. So I have nowhere to sell business. Then for 2-3 months, I cannot sell even a single also. But anyway, I buy some of the product, servicing product from Guwahati, and I used to go to door-to-door for selling the product. Then only people come to know that servicing is good for the lighting system. Because the government has given it freely, but they don't do any servicing. Then after that, I used to attend some of the meetings, sort of the Selha group meeting, Panchayat meeting, and introduce about the solar energy, solar lighting system that time. then only people come to know that he is doing a good business, good quality of product. But in between that, I have challenges, a lot of challenges in my place. Number one, transportation system, transportation problem. Especially in the rainy season, we cannot deliver to the customer door to door because of the rainy season, starting from landslide, heavy rain, I could not go. And then also, we have to go on foot by carrying the product door to door. Then, exactly that time, people recognize me that I'm sacrificing. So now the people knew that, the public, the customer knew that, they only come to my office and face the things. They are helping me for transportation also. Then another challenge is that no one is financing in my business there. The people, they want solar lighting system, but they don't have the capacity to buy the solar system. They want the solar light, but they don't have the capacity. They are searching, they are seeking for the financing system, but no one can finance there. There is only two banks there, local bank and SBI is there. We went two times with Sir Hegre also, but totally they are not refused to give the finance, but they are pending our proposal till now. Then after that, I got a government supply installation from Subhagya scheme, which is given by Sydney company. Then till this year also I got a Subhagya scheme, that is a Lord's company. 2500 system I got for installation till now. So there is a lot of challenge in my place. But now automatically it's come positively, because all the rural areas are given by the government free of cost. And opposite, the towns area demanding, yeah, for light system. High demand for home lighting system, because lots of hours are power cut in the town area. And in the village area, in the remote area, there are 24 hours of power supply. Automatically come to the town area. Then day by day, the town areas, all our service holders, they used to come to my office and asking for the solar home lighting system. So it's come a very positive green signal for me. So now I am thinking that I can do this business, and this is a sustainable energy business. Because I don't think that this is a sustainable business. One I saw, I cannot get this system from another place. But now I can understand this is a sustainable business, and everyone is searching for me now. It's for livelihood system and home lighting system. Wherever I go, the people, all the people of villagers, peoples, they meet me, they used to call me, and they used to come to my house also. And they used to ask solar system, how to get a solar lighting system, because they cannot buy, they are seeking for the financial system. Not only that, they want for the livelihood system, that's all.
Okay. So from what I'm hearing from you also, there's a lot of trust that is there between you and the customer, or a lot of connect that you have with the community.
Yeah.
How did you mentioned a number of these challenges, like there was a transport issue, there's an issue of awareness, there's an issue of financing, but yet you see this growing demand for livelihood. And you're also, you've been able to do a few of these systems, about 25 systems, and I assume this is going to be increasing for you. How have you been able to do the 25 that you've done so far? I mean, what have been the mix of things that you've been able to do to actually sell it in such an area?
Exactly, first of all, I select some of the areas which is supported by the SELCO for demos. With that demos, so many of the customers, they saw that demos, then are coming for inquiries. Then I select SDG, local, there is an area wise, 20-25 village, there is a head. I used to contact that head of that area, then I put him as a BA. According to that BA, he searched the customer, then he bring to me or give information.
So a BA is a business associate,
yes.
Which is a commissioned
agent. Yeah, commission system.
And what about for the financing?
purpose, I don't know if I got that purpose that you were done for the financing. Because of, how did you crack the end user financing?
After given demo stem, I found 25 customer as inquiries. Mm. So for this, I give the information to SELCO, and before that, so many time we went to the bank, but they refused to give us a fine or a loan. So I think SELCO has support me as a revolving fund to give them as a financing system or EMI. Then with this EMI or financing system now become demand high demands of livelihood system also.
Thank you for that. Now moving on to I think Patil sir from SELCO India. So you manage a branch since 2012 that's been there by long run, which is in North Karnataka. Again, for a lot of people in the room who have not been to North Karnataka, a very difficult region sometimes to work in. I think last year there were about 1,300 systems that were sold from lighting and about 67 livelihood systems. I'm just curious, I think a lot of people in the room know SELCO for lighting. And now, you know, we're moving into this, you know, whole livelihood systems. How have you been able, or what are the activities or efforts that were required to make the shift from lighting to livelihoods? You have to convince customers. Or what are the sort of efforts that were required for that? In the process, the challenges that you have to overcome.
Hello. Good evening, everyone. My name is K.S. Patil, Bhagwat branch manager. पहले जो अभी मैडम ने बात कर रही थी 2012 में मैंने SELCO ज्वाइन किया उस समय जो लाइटिंग का जो मैं कन्नड़ में बोल देता हूँ वो ट्रांसलेट कर देगा क्योंकि हिंदी थोड़ा कमजोर है इसलिए 2012 ನಾನು ಕಂಪನಿ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆದಾಗ ಸೆಲ್ಕೋ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆದಾಗ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಏನು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಏನು ಬೈ ನಮ್ಮ ಏರಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಏನು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಏನು ಇದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ನಿರಂತರ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ ಇತ್ತು
ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ಜಾಯಿನ್ SELCO ಇನ್ 2012 ಹಿ ಡಿಡ್ನ್ಟ್ ಸೀ ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ನಿರಂತರ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ ವಿಚ್ ವಾಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ಲಿ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ರೂರಲ್ ಹೌಸ್ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ಸ್
ಅವೊಂದು ವೇಳೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಅವೇರ್ನೆಸ್ ಮೂಡಿಸೋದೇ ಒಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕೆಲಸ ಆಗಿತ್ತು ಆ ಮೂಲಕವಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಡೆಮೋ ಮಾಡೋದಾಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ನಿಂದ ಅವೇರ್ನೆಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡೋದಾಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ನಿತರೆ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ
ದಿ ಬಿಗ್ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್ ವಾಸ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಟು ಟಾಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ 2012 ಸರ್ 2013 ಸೊ ದಿ ಬಿಗ್ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್ ವಾಸ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಅವೇರ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸಸ್ಟೈನಬಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ People thought, why do I have to have solar? So that was the biggest challenge during that time.
But ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಒಂದು ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಒಂದು ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಿನ ಮೂಲಕವಾಗಿ ನಾವು ನಿಮಗೊಂದು ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದನ್ನೇ ನಮಗೆ ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗಿತ್ತು ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಒಂಚೂರು ಎಲ್ಲ ಡೀಲರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ದವರೆಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂಚೂರು ಸೋಲಾರ್ ಅನ್ನೋದ್ರ ಹೆಸರನ್ನ ಹಾಳಾಗ್ತಿದ್ರು
So the other biggest challenge was when financing was a problem, right? So when they went to the when they tried for financial linkage, because of the previous enterprises who are their previous dealers, you know, people who just buy the product and distribute it, so they had actually kind of spoiled this name of solar systems because of bad servicing, bad maintenance. So if when he went to the banks would say, no, the system hasn't worked. Why do we have to finance? So that was one of the biggest hurdle to tackle.
ಅದೇ ನಮ್ಗೊಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾನಿತ್ತು ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನು ಅದನ್ನು ಕೊಡಂಗಿರಿ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕರೆಂಟಿನ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ನಾವು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಏನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೆನರ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಬಾರಿ ನಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯೊಳಗೆ ಕೊರಿತೇವೆ ನಾವು ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿನ ಸಮಾಜದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವನದೇ ಆದ ಒಂದು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಾಳ್ಬೇಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಒಂದು ಉದ್ಯೋಗ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹಚ್ಬೇಕಂತ ನಮ್ಮ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಿತ್ತು
So he had a great, I mean, he knew that the solar solutions cannot stop at home lighting. So he had this intention of working with SELCO that ultimately entrepreneurship would be a solution in places like North Karnataka, because if the solutions have to reach the last mile, not a big company can go into the service. So he wanted the local, the micro entrepreneurs to actually pick up the problems and provide the solutions to the
ಮೇಡಮ್ ಅವ್ರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು ಏನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಲೈವ್ಲಿಹುಡ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿಯನ್ನು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರ ಅಂತ. ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ನಾವು ಯಾವ ರೇಂಜಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಇದನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ಆ ಉದ್ಯೋಗವನ್ನು ನಾನೇ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಅದರ ಪೂರ್ವಪರವನ್ನು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ನಾವು ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ, ಆ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಕಸ್ಟಮರಿಗೂ ಆ ಲೆವೆಲ್ಲಿ ಇಳಿದು ಆಳವಾಗಿ ಅಧ್ಯಯನ ಮಾಡಿನೇ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಇದನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಅವ್ರು ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆಗುವಂಥ ಚಾನ್ಸಸ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ.
ಸೊ ಹಿ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಸಾರಾ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಹಿಮ್ how did you start with livelihood? I mean, what are the things you look at when you implement livelihood solutions? He says one of the first things he does is he puts himself in the customer's shoes. If I am a blacksmith, yeah, if I am a potter, so what would it take for me to have the solution in a better way? So that's the first thing he would do. He would think himself as the end user and then look at the solution and then look at the needs.
ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅವರು ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ ಕಡೆ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ, ಫೈಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಆನಂತರ ಅವ್ರದ್ದೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಲಿಂಕೇಜು ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ವೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಆನಂತರ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಫೈನಾನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಿ ಆನಂತರ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿಸಿ ಆನಂತರ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಲಿಂಕೇಜನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಗೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಸೆಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಅದರಿಂದಾಗಿ ಅವರು ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ ಆಗೋಕ್ಕೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಈಸಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ.
ಸೊ ಹಿ ಸೇಸ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ being with the end user in all stages. It's not just you implement the technology and then you walk away. So he will be there with the end user during the implementation, during to create the market linkages and to see actually the implementation is making a difference. If not, then ask the question and then actually try tweaking the solution, be it financing solution, be it the technological solution, be it the market linkage solution. So how would that solution be more effective?
ಕೆಲವೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ಬರೀ ಲೈಟಿಂಗ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಹೇಳಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಹೋಟೆಲ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ಕಿರಾಣಿ ಶಾಪ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ನಿತರ ಒಂದು ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೀ ಲೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್ ಅಷ್ಟು ಇದಾಗ್ತಿರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಬರುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ಸಲ್ಯೂಷನನ್ನು ನಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೂಚನೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೀ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಷ್ಟೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನು ಈ ಟೈಪ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಟ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಕೂಡ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಮನವರಿಕೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡುವಂಥ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್.
ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ whenever that he gets a request for lighting solution, a home lighting solution, or be it a lighting solution for a small hotel or a restaurant, so he goes there and tells, see, I mean, lighting is good, of course it gives you light, but it doesn't create you any other source of income generation. So he'll suggest, depending on the need, if it's a hotel, he'll tell this might be another solution you can look upon. So he will go and tell them that there are solutions beyond home lighting, depending on the context.
Example helbekandre hotel indre now fridge enna madabodu anantara kirani shop athwa hotel ku kuda now yavdu xerox machine annu kuda aagabodu athwa hotel ge now roti machine annu kodabodu andre multi aagi now alli kelsa madu riti madidre avaru income one to double anna definitely now raise madabodu.
As an example, you already heard about it. So if he goes to a hotel, there are a couple of solutions they can look at. It could be a last mile refrigeration system, or it could be, since it's North Karnataka where the demand for roti, the Indian bread is high, so he could suggest them to have the roti making machine so that it will add to their income as well. Or if it's a petty store, then we can suggest them to have a solar power photocopier or a printing machine as well.
ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಈಗ ಒಂದು ಲೈವ್ಲಿಹುಡ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಅದರೊಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ನಾವು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡೋಂಗೆ ಇದನ್ನು ಸೆಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಟ್ರೆ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಗೆ ಎಟ್ ಎ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ಟೈಮ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಲ್ದೇ ಅವರು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ವೇ ಇದೆ. ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇದನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಾವು ಇನ್ನೂ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಅನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಫೈಡ್ ಮನೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಲೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡೋದಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಈಗ ಮಾಡಲ್ ಡೈರಿ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಇಂಥದ್ದೆಲ್ಲ ಸುಮಾರಷ್ಟು ನಾವು ಬ್ರಾಂಚ್ ಲೆವೆಲಿಂದ ನಮ್ಮ ಫೌಂಡೇಶನ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ನಾವು ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದೇನಂತಂದರೆ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮದೊಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನದಿಂದಾಗಿ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಕುಟುಂಬಗಳು ಅವರವರ ಲೆವೆಲಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಂತು ತಾವೇ ತಮ್ಮ ಕಾಲ ಮೇಲೆ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಂದು ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾವೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನನಗೆ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ.
he says, I mean, if a little effort from our side, from the enterprise side, if it could bring bring a family sustainable source of income, it could make that one person or a small family to stand upon, you know, stand on their legs and actually make them sustainable, their legs sustainable. I think the efforts, I mean, worth it. So he feels proud that through the efforts over the last few years, that those impacts have been made, and he has started seeing the fruits from the efforts.
So I mean, so what I'm hearing, I mean, is I think the same thing with Joysing servers. There are a number of various hats that I think one has to wear as an enterprise, whether it's identification, whether it's going to the customer, whether it's convincing the banker, whether it's just convincing the customer, a number of those things. And then even after you sell the livelihood system, the market image of something like that, which is something that very often, from what I'm understanding, you had to sort of help support the end user to do that, or they come up with ideas. So this seems to be a number of things that an enterprise has to do. So with that, I just want to segue a bit to another type of model with Sudeshna and Linda working in Jharkhand and in West Bengal. Again, a little different from the model that Patil sir and Joysing sir were talking about in terms of standalone systems and livelihood products. Maybe you can sort of give us a sense of the sort of model that MLinda is working on and how you have addressed those sort of livelihood issues. So I know that you've helped with 25 mini grids, there are about 300 micro entrepreneurs that you've worked with. So how have you, in your model, sort of planned the livelihood solution?
Thanks, Sarah, and a very good afternoon to all. I'll just start by giving a little background to the work that we do in Jharkhand and Gumla district. So we have deployed about 25 solar village level mini grids there, powering the energy needs of the entire village. And we want to scale it up to 50 mini grids with an installed capacity of 1 megawatt by June 2020. But for MLinda as an organization, this is just a platform for engaging very deeply with the local tribal and the rural communities to build enterprises, to grow productive loads, last mile enterprises I mean, and to have a very sustainable impact on local economic development. So in this process, we have, as Sarah said, that we have incubated and we have impacted about 300 micro enterprises across our operational villages in Gumla, Jharkhand. And it ranges from agri-based enterprises pertaining to irrigation pumps, small and big irrigation pumps, rice hullers, oil millers, corn millers, then pulverizers. And on the non-agri side, we are also working in a very, very focused manner on growing the off-farm loads, such as cold storages, EVs, electric vehicles, as a last-mile public transportation, as well as poultry coops. So these are the range of the enterprises that we are working closely with the communities to impact and address. So in doing so, we have taken on various roles, something which also Prerna in her debrief kind of focused on, right from identification of the right technology to access to end user finance, because as we all know, institution finance is not easily available to the end users. Third, access to markets. Fourth, the repair and the service mechanisms, and very good reliable electricity supply. And here I would like to make a mention of in terms of electricity supply, it's not only single phase electricity supply that we do in our operational villages, but also we supply our enterprises and end users 24/7 three-phase supply. So why I make a special mention of the three-phase supply is it that it goes a long way in impacting collective enterprises in the village, which really builds economies of scale. So it's a mix of off-farm, on-farm enterprises, as well as single-phase energized and three-phase energized enterprises in the villages. And last but not the least, the role which MLinda takes, ours is a very, very socially embedded model that we have on the ground. So apart from all the above, what I have stated, the different hats that we wear in terms of a ecosystem builder, we also work across the value chain very, very deeply with the communities to create a trust. So for me, enterprise building for MLinda, the last mile sustainable enterprises, is not only a function of technology, finance, access to markets, but also function of local trust and respect and empathy, as Patil sir also pointed out. So this is also what we do in working very close quarters with the communities in Jharkhand, Gumla. And we are drawing from the MLinda experience, also on the, I would like to also comment on this, that since we are operating on the micro mini grid and the micro grid domain, this concept of building sustainable last mile enterprises is not only about impacting local economies, growing incomes, building community resilient mechanisms, but also goes a long way in strengthening the commercial viability of the mini grid model as a whole, because it impacts two key things in a mini grid model. One is the mini grid utilization, and second, it impacts the revenue realizations. So these, when from a debtor's point of view, when they look at kind of financing the mini grid model and to scale it up or to replicate it, so these are the two key factors impacting the decisions of the financiers. So it was a long way in building the commercial credibility and viability of the model itself.
So if I can ask you, like you had mentioned a number of things that is a lender you do. I mean, I'm curious whether, so the tech development part of it. So for example, to find the right technology for the livelihood. And then of course there's a financing component and then the market linkage component. So these are roles that you take on completely. So do you have a tech development key team as well? Then you have a team that does the collections for the financing, and then you have also a market linkage component. Maybe you could just expand.
We have a technical team who looks into the community requirements, who engages very closely with the community to understand their requirements on the ground and work with the technology solutions that is there in the market, or to innovate or to kind of tinker and to make it very appropriate for the end user. So we have that team in place, and financing is something that we are doing internally. We are very, very clear about it. We are doing it because it's only for a demonstration effect, because we want to demonstrate to the institutional financiers, to the bankers, that yes, the business model works on the ground level. Yes, the end user can repay. And it is profitable at the end of the day. So once we have the banker's confidence, we are really wanting to connect the end user to institutional financing. So this is something which is very, very interim in the model, that we are doing to prove a point, but we want, when we scale up, we want the institutional financing to happen in our model. And marketing is also something, again, which we are doing internally now at the ground level for 25-50 grids maybe, but with scale and with replication, we really want to partner with a market entity partner to market the products that we are producing in partnership with the community.
Yeah, because I think somewhere the roles that you mentioned, these are all sort of very what everyone was saying, very difficult to kind of crack. And so if you were to, would you say that this was by necessity, or going forward this is something that you would want to partner with someone to hive off? And if there was one part of that chain, which one would it be? Because these are sort of, all these activities are something being done by one entity. And I'm curious whether, did you do it because there was no one else doing it and therefore you took on these roles? But if you were to hive off one bit, what would it be? Because what has been the cost of taking on so many roles as an enterprise?
In a way you are right, because this is something we took on very consciously in the model, the mini grid model, because we never wanted our mini grid model to be only access to clean electricity. Because we wanted our mini grid model to go beyond that and to impact local incomes, to impact village level GDP growth, and to build sustainable enterprises at the end of the day. So, but we had to prove it, because it's difficult. We are operating in a very difficult terrain, in that of Gumla district of Jharkhand, which is very underserved, unserved. So we just wanted to kind of showcase and prove that yes, it is possible. So we took on the various roles, that of a technology provider, that of a financier, that of doing the sales and marketing bit of it, and of course the community engagement part is there. So we took it on consciously to prove the model that it works. But it finally, when we scale it up, we go forward, we really want to, as I said, outsource different components of this model, the first being the financing part. So that is, we first and foremost, we really want to do away with, but the process has been it's a build-on kind of a thing. We have to work with the financiers, we have to work with the banks in order to sensitize them to the end user, you know, the demands and the requirements on the ground. So this is something we have taken on right now, but of course, going forward, we would like to outsource some of the components.
Well, moving not very far from you, to Alicia, you know, if I can, you know, speak to Upendra Ji from Tarini Enterprises.
Tarini Enterprises, Upendra Sahoo, by the way.
So, so we definitely want you, you know, to understand your story, sir. I know that you've been working for 20 years, I think, as an entrepreneur. But just recently got into being an energy entrepreneur, maybe in 2015. So I have Anukriti just sort of ask you whether what has been your story, like what is the sort of energy business that you have done in Odisha, and what has been sort of, you're working in a tribal area, so what has been the challenges for that particular area that you have been working in?
Theater post mein salaar se kaam kar raha hu, kyunki mera kaam pehle theek nahi tha. 2015 mein jab SELCO se juda hu tab se mera kaam thoda quality hua. इंस्टॉलेशन के बारे में कैसे लोगों को समझाने के बारे में, तो जब काम मैंने शुरू किया 2015 से पहला काम, तो मैं पहले मेरा चैलेंज ये था कि मैं लोगों के पास कैसे सोलर को पहुँचा. अगर मैं लोगों को के पास सोलर पहुँचा के सोलर मैंने बनूँ तो लोग उसके बाद मेरे पास आए. तो इसके लिए मुझे बहुत कुछ करना पड़ा, काम हम मीटिंग करना पड़ा. हम लोग का 40 ब्लॉक है, 40 ब्लॉक में हम लोग सरपंच एक एक सरपंच करके पकड़ के मीटिंग पहले किया. तो उसके बाद कुछ पोस्टर बनाया, कुछ बैनर बनाया. तो आपका जो पॉपुलेशन एरिया है, जो इसे चौक एरिया है, आपका हाथों एरिया है, उस एरिया में हम लोग वो बैनर पर लगाया. तो उसके बाद हम सबको से लोन लेके 15 सिस्टम प्लस हमारे तरफ से 5 सिस्टम 10 का हम लगा.
Work around 2015 full-fledged in solar, and his main issue while starting was like, how should he reach out to the end user? What are the different ways that he can adopt to reach out to the end user? And one of the ways he adopted was to reach out to Sarpanch of these 40 blocks and put out different advertising materials to reach out to the end users about his solar organization.
उसके बाद हम लोग को कुछ गांव वालों ने बुला के कुछ जो हम लोग इस गांव में 5 टू उस गांव में 10 टू इसे ऑर्डर भी आया हम लोग के पास. तो उसके बाद जो और एक चैलेंज है, उन लोगों को कैसे सोलर पहुंचा जाए. तो उन लोग बहुत गरीब एरिया है, गरीब एरिया में उन लोगों के पास पैसा नहीं. कौन बोला हम 500 देंगे, 1000 देंगे. तो उसके बाद हम लोगों ने सेटल किया SELCO से, भी SELCO से बात किया, उन लोगों ने बैंकों को आश्वस्त किया कि 2-3 बार बैंकों को आश्वस्त. बैंक वालों ने भी ऐसे करके बहुत मैंने डिजर्व जिडर करके इसे फर्स्ट 10 टू विदाउट बिग स्पून में हम लोग को एक गांव में लगाने का अडॉप्ट किया था. तो वो बड़कलाड़ी नाम का एक ग्राम पंचायत है, उसी में पहले पारोटू एक पंडा नाम का एक बैंक मैनेजर था, उन्होंने पहले विदाउट बिग स्पून लेके हमको 12 सिस्टम लगाने का अडॉप्ट किया था. तो उसके बाद सोलर का डिमांड इसे इसे आस्ते आस्ते हो गया. तो भी हम लोग को बैंक की तरफ से 120 पीस बैंक के ऑर्डर से लगाया हो, और भी बैंक में 60 पीस का सोलर दिया है. तो इसे रिवोल्यूशन फंड के बारे में, रिवोल्यूशन फंड और 2-3 एनजीओ के साथ काम करके करीबन हमने 600 होम लाइटिंग सिस्टम कंप्लीट अभी तो किया है. तो उसके बाद ऐसे अपने आप हम लोग को जो हम लोग होम लाइटिंग ये लाइट ब्लू का सिस्टम 2017 से स्टार्ट किया. 2017 से शरत नाम का गांव है, शरत आपका कत्तीबुदा ब्लॉक में शरत नाम का पंचायत है, पंचायत का गांव है. तो उनको लाइट ब्लू कैसे पहुंचा जाए, तो हम एक दिन हमारा एक स्टाफ के साथ गया, चलो उस दुकान में छोटा सा पान दुकान था, जंगल का एरिया था पूरा जंगल, इसी एरिया में हम एक टू LS के बजट गए. तो ठीक है, उन लोग जाकर बोला तो यहाँ से जरक्स फरस करते हो कितना डिस्टेंस है ना, 15 किलोमीटर डिस्टेंस है. तो यहाँ पकाने से कितना, यहाँ तो लाइन नहीं है कैसे जरक्स फरस चलेगा. तो हम चला देंगे, उनको बोला चला देंगे तो कितना कष्ट लगेगा, हमें 1,20,000 करीबन लगेगा, इतना पैसा तो हम नहीं दे सकते, कितना दो 30-40 हजार दो, नहीं 5-10 हजार देंगे, तो बोला वो तो ये पाँच, वो भी लगाने के बाद एक महीने के बाद बोला कि नहीं ठीक है। तो हम लोग भी उनको से बात किया, उन्होंने फर्स्ट उनको इसे दिया हो ठीक है करेंगे, उनको जाकर सर्वे करके देखा वो जगह चलेगा। तो अभी वो जो एल एस के सेंटर है बहुत अच्छा चलता है, विदाउट ये इलेक्ट्रिक से चलता है। तो ऐसे हम लोग 6 एल एस के प्रोजेक्ट किया है। तो अभी यही में इस महीना फेब्रुआरी में हम लोग के ये प्रोजेक्ट देख के बैंक वालों को बुलाया। पहले वजी बैंक ने
people were ready to give like 500,000 rupees a month, but not as a lump sum amount. So as a solution, he said that let's mobilize bankers for it, and the initial bankers training was done. In that, I think a champion bankers was identified, and some initial 10 loans were done without risk guarantee. From that, his business picked up, and the more needs were identified, and eventually he moved from home lighting system to livelihoods. The area that he works in is an extremely tribal area. The population is sparse. It's like very, very like segregated. So one of the key starts for his livelihood was, I think, a photocopier machine. The Lok Seva Kendra that we call it as. And he identified a petty shop in middle of a village. And he asked him like, how far is the closest photo shop that you have access to? And people said like 15 to 20 kilometers is the closest one. So he said, why don't you adopt this as a solution with your petty shop? He said, but we don't have grid connection. He said, we've got it. But I think the cost was like 1,20,000 of whole system because there was nothing. So photocopier machine with a solar solution. And I think they were negotiating with the end user. And he said, acha, how much will you give? They said, we'll give, can you give 40,000? No, we can give 10,000. And then finally, it was put up a demo system and then they converted into a sale. And from now, he has done like 6 such systems in these villages which are very far off, providing access to Lok Seva Kendra and the e-services to the end users. And,
तीन बैंक में, एक आपका ओजी में ओडिशा ग्रामीण बैंक, सिंडिकेट बैंक, यूनाइटेड बैंक, तीन बैंक वालों को हम वो जो एल एस के पावर दिखाया था, एल एस एस का ब्लर बैंक हमको दिखाया था, ब्लर जो क्या ब्लर तीन को ब्लर हमने किया दिखाया था। वो देख के तो पहले ओजी वालों ने बोला दे देंगे, 6 डॉक्यूमेंट्स लेके उनको दिया, नहीं किया उन्होंने, नहीं किया। तो उसके बाद सिंडिकेट ब्रांच में, सिंडिकेट ब्रांच हम लोग का उपला का ब्रांच और बुराडिया का ब्रांच, तो दो ब्रांच में दो टू पहले किया है, फेब्रुवरी महीना में किया है। एक बैंक ने डिस्काउंट लेके गया, एक बैंक ने विदाउट डिस्काउंट में, लेकिन बैंक वाला ने बोला कि क्यों डिस्काउंट ले ना, हम लोग का पहला कस्टमर है तो सिक्स मंथ अगर उनका अकाउंट होता तो हम डिस्काउंट नहीं ले। तो उसके बाद हम जो एक ब्लोअर के पास गए तो ब्लोअर वाला ने ऐसे साइकिल चक्का घुमा के काम कर रहे थे। तो मैं बोला कि वो भाई तुम साइकिल चला रहे तो आपको एक मशीन देंगे, आपका पूरा काम होगा। बोला हाँ, तो कितना आपका डेली जाता है ना, हम लोग का 250 रुपया मुजरी जाता है, बोलते 250 रुपया हमको खाना करना पड़ता है, तो कब आता है कब नहीं आता है। तो अभी इसे करके चलाता है। तो ये भी सड़क पंचायत में छोटा एरिया है, तो कमर्स हॉल है, उसी में हम एक आदिवासी लोग हैं और उनको जाके ठीक है। तो उनको देखे एक ब्रोशर दे गया तो उनको भी अच्छा लगा ब्रोशर, वो भी पैसा 2000 पहले दिया था, ऐसे करके आहिस्ता आहिस्ता करके कुछ कुछ देते हैं। तो अम्मी हमारे पास वो तीन ब्लॉर ऐसे काम हुआ है। अभी हमारे पास एक प्रोजेक्ट दिया है 100 ब्लॉर को, एक ढोकरा प्रोजेक्ट है, ढोकरा प्रोजेक्ट में उनका पूरा गाँव इसे काम करता है, उनका 100 ब्लॉर का जरूरत है, सब ऐसे हाथ के मशीन से घुरा के काम करते हैं। उनको प्रोजेक्ट कैसे होगा, किसके तरफ होगा, वो बातचीत चल रहा है, तो देखें।
So he was able to mobilize funds for his LSK through 2 banks, one without risk guarantee and one with risk guarantee. That is like one model that he has explored. And the other thing that he is saying, that how he is convincing the end users to adopt sustainable energy solutions, is that he shows them as, like, as everybody said, like DevOps as one of the important mediums to showcase the technology to the end user. And with this, he has identified a place with Dogra craft. It's a metal casting craft in which there's a village of 100 end users. Now he's working on that project to mobilize financing for these 100 end users for blacksmith brewers.
If I can ask you, of all the things that you mentioned, it seemed that finance, what is the most difficult for you in...
Most difficult for financing. तो बैंक वालों ने इसे मैनेजर बोल देते हैं तो फाइनेंस कर देंगे फील्ड ऑप्शन नहीं दो और मैं वो जी भी क्यों बोला भाई देखिए वो तो मैं वो आपका कस्टमर है जो जो एलएस के दिया ने एलएस का कस्टमर वो जी भी का है सिंडिकेट का कस्टमर नहीं है सिंडिकेट ने उनको उनका अकाउंट भी नहीं था सिंडिकेट ने फाइनेंस किया और जी भी तो फाइनेंस नहीं किया तो प्रॉब्लम होता है ओनली बैंक का नहीं तो लोगों अगर सोलर एक लोगों को ऐसे दिमाग में भी है सोलर एक लेजर से क्या क्या पॉइंट आएगा उनको भी समझाना पड़ता है अगर वो समझ जाए तो सोलर क्या चीज है वो सोलर में नहीं चलेगा इलेक्ट्रिक छोड़ देगा तो हम कुछ इस घर में भी ऐसे होम लाइटिंग लगाए बहुत ही लाइट एक छोटा सा फैन लगाए तो उनको तो हमारा लाइन है ठीक है लाइन है तुम ये दो रूम में दो बल्ब को बंद कर दो बल्ब महीना में 100 रुपया तो बच जाएगा आपका इसे भी कुछ घर को हम समझा के दिया है तो दो घर रूम में दो लाइन लगा दो तुम्हारा लाइन था कोई भी रिमोनेशन फोन के बारे में इस काम हुआ था गाँव में तुम दो लाइन बंद कर दो पूरा पूरा टोटल ऑफ कर दो लाइन को खोल दो अब दो लाइन खरीदेंगे तो 100-100 उसको बिल भी देंगे 40 रुपये आएगा महीना की 50 रुपये आएगा उसको तो बंद हो जाएगा ना इसे करके लोगों को कुछ समझाना पड़ता है और मेन क्रिटिकल है बैंक फाइनेंशियल बैंक वाला देंगे नहीं वो बोलेंगे हम सब एक बैंक में सबको प्रोजेक्ट दिया है हर वालों ने भी गया था हमारे साथ एक बैंक में सबको प्रोजेक्ट दिया है उनका सामने सार वाले को सामने ही उनको जा सर हम प्रोजेक्ट दिया आप क्यों नहीं देंगे ना हमारा मर्जी तो होगा हम देंगे सर बोलो दे पूरा हमारा मर्जी 70% दिया 10% दिया एक ऐसी जगह का दिया एक ऐसी जगह का क्यों दिया वो तो गुस्सा से किसी को लेने वाला है अब देखें देखें देखें
So he's saying that it doesn't matter if the banker says yes, ultimately when they go on the field officer sometimes says no. So he has faced continuous issues with availing finance through banks and it has times happened that he has taken the end user of one bank and told the bank that this is your end user only, he has an account in your bank, why aren't you giving him the loan? So that bank hasn't given the loan, whereas the bank where the end user doesn't have an account, the other bank has given the loan. So for him, there is no particular calculation of which bank will give, which will not give. He doesn't know because there are various factors. So he is saying that we have gone with SELCO team various times to banks and we have asked them that these are your SDGs, why aren't you giving the loans? And the bank managers have told, it is our wish, we'll give whenever we want to give. Or whenever we have time. So that has been an issue. And then he's also talking about his this thing about how to mobilize end user for adopting solutions where the basic the grid is already there. So he has right now done a 50 home lighting solution with one of the NGOs as a partner. And we have done it through the revolving fund model. But there the at some of the parts the grid was there, but how did he actually influence the end user to adopt this sustainable energy solution is like he goes there and he tells them that you remove these two bulbs, you remove it, then you will see the impact of your electricity bill. Put solar and then we'll see it for a month and see how it goes.
सर एक बैंक वालों को मैं 15 दिन पहले पत्तूरा ब्रांच ऊंची भी ब्रांच में गया था 30 हाउस को लोगों को जेल में उन्होंने बोला हम दे देंगे वो ठीक है सर दे देंगे तुम चल चल नहीं नहीं ऐसे नहीं देंगे सर कैसे देंगे ना बोला कि 30 हाउसहोल्ड का लोन आपका नाम में कर देता हूँ आप उसको दे दीजिए पेमेंट हमको महीना का दे दीजिए आपको मैं चलता हूँ जो भी बैंक को पकड़ो बोलते हैं कि पेमेंट पे रिस्क लोगे तो हम देंगे पेमेंट पे रिस्क
सर इधर सौरभ कुमार का हम लोग का 45 सिस्टम का इधर लोन हुआ था 35 का एनपीए हो गया हमको चिट्ठी कर दिया सेल्को को से चिट्ठी कर दिया सेल्को से मेल गया हम लोग हमारी तरफ से उनको इक्वली रिकवर कर तो 35 सिस्टम रिकवर अभी दो सिस्टम बाकी है हर दिन मैनेजर हमको दो लोगों ने दिया नहीं हर दिन मैनेजर हमको पता वो लोग जो दो लोग बाकी रहा आपका दिया नहीं सलाह के पेमेंट अरे भाई तुम लोग को इंटरेस्ट लोगे हम क्या करेंगे तो टोटली उनको मैनेजर को इंटरेस्ट नहीं लेता रिटर्न में वो उनको क्या होता है जी अगर वो सोलह लोग घर में लगाए तो उनका कोई सैलरी नहीं बढ़ेगा कि नहीं लगाए तो नहीं सैलरी बढ़ेगा तो उनका क्यों इंटरेस्ट देते थे और बोला कि तुम 2-3 लाख का प्रोजेक्ट ला हम दे देंगे ये जो छोटा मोटा प्रोजेक्ट लेने के लिए तो भी मैं बहुत कोशिश करके 3-4 बैंक में 110 करीबन प्रोजेक्ट किया है और भी 30-40 प्रोजेक्ट मैंने पढ़ा तो वो देंगे नहीं देंगे उनका ऊपर मर्जी है तो बोला कि हम प्रोजेक्ट 70 देते हैं 2 देते हैं इसे हम करेंगे करेंगे बोलेंगे तो पर मना नहीं करेंगे सर मना भी मेरी मैडम वालों गया था और जो ब्रांच को क्या हुआ कैसे तकलीफ होता है
That's one more story from the ground that he's sharing. He's saying that he went to the bank manager for 30 household loans, and he's like, so bank manager is like, okay, we'll give the loan. So he's like, come, let's go on the field for the loan. He's like, no, I'll give it to you. You take the liability, and then you give it to them. So he's saying, like an entrepreneur, the managers are expecting the entrepreneur to take on the liability for the repayment of the loan. He has one of the cases where they have done 40 loans to the bank, and 30 of the loans went through NPA. So the bank manager called SELCO, bank manager called him. And the team went on the ground and did the recovery, but there were still two people who had not repaid. So there were constant calls to the entrepreneurs, like why the repayment is not happening. So he's saying that that's the bank's role also to do it, because they are the ones who are taking the interest for the recollection, for providing the services to the end users. That is their role, to provide the accessible finance for the end users in the rural areas. So, but when they go for loans, the liability comes on their head for the collection, for finding out the correct end users to do the paperwork. So that is not something that he is able to understand. But in spite of all this, he is able to mobilize loans, and which is like commendable, from 3 to 4 banks. And he's saying that I've done 110 loans from banks, and he's also expecting another 40-50 in the coming time.
So I think, thank you, Upendra. I think that was a nice way to articulate it. So I think the resilience of knowing that, yes, even though financing is a barrier, I think if I ask everyone which is a barrier, I suppose that would be the number one thing. But I think sort of understanding that there is a demand, there is a clear demand, but sort of the one of the, I would say the criticisms that you hear is, oh, it's not scaling fast, or it's not moving fast enough. But I think part of the issue is that also the number of roles that an enterprise has to take on, if he did not have to chase after this financing, maybe it could have been a different story. And I think that's part of the challenge to all of us in this room. You know, how do you make some of those things easier? So it doesn't fall on the enterprise to be able to do it. I think somewhere, I think there's an expectation that they will do everything, or all these systems are already in place. But that doesn't seem to be the case clearly from Upendraji's, you know, sort of stories. But so moving on, I mean, again, to the eastern part of India still, and with our final panelist, Ekta from ONganic. Clearly, again, an organization, ONganic, but 2-3 arms of organizations. Maybe you can speak to everybody speak. I think you're obviously an energy enterprise, but you're also, there were different entities that started to take on different roles at different points. Maybe you can speak to that a little bit, because I know that there was something with skilling there, and then there was something with market linkages. So maybe you can also speak to, I think, why you had to take on those different roles. Different entities that had to be created as part of the project.
Sure. So one very interesting thing that I have sort of realized over the years is that when you enter the space of social entrepreneurship or rural development, you, and I think we also heard this through the day,
you're not there to sell a product, you're not there to do a project, you're there to find a solution to a problem that bothers you. And I think everyone in this space sort of goes with that drive and passion that we want to find an answer, you know, how can you make this work? And so every time you sort of, you start with the first problem. So when we sort of decided that we wanted to work in the clean energy space, the first problem that we sort of faced was in West Bengal, people were not really aware about clean energy. So we thought that was a big problem. So we did a lot of this awareness programs and this creative outreach, etc. So once we sort of crossed that first barrier and sort of people got excited about solar and sort of they said, yeah, we want to buy solar. And we, at that point, we were sort of very new in this space, we were promoting solar lights. And we suddenly realized that people were not interested in lights. So they, to new people, they wanted something much larger, like they've seen lights in the homes and, you know, TVs and fans. And so they were like, we already have a kerosene lamp, so can we have something larger? And also, I think they had also seen in neighboring villages, you know, through government programs. So they said, no, we don't want this, we want larger home systems. So you go with an idea thinking that this is an affordable solution, but it's not aspiring enough. And so you go back and then you design a larger home system. And then you're like, now I have the solution. This is what they want. And then you take it back to them. And then they're like, this is too expensive. We can't buy this. This is very expensive. And I think it was around the same time also that we got incubated by SELCO. And so this whole financing piece sort of fell into place. And initially, like some of these organizations, we did some financing ourselves. We realized that it was not a space that we really wanted to be in. And so then we got some bank financing happening. Once that challenge, it's never cracked enough, but once you sort of feel like you have cracked it, you suddenly realize that you're working in extreme remote areas and, you know, your centers are about 3-4 hours away and your customers are like rivers and, you know, whatever away. And when there is a breakdown, servicing becomes a big challenge. You have to send people that far and then, you know, what do you do? And so this is around that time that, so when we sort of realized that it's very important to have these local ecosystem built where, you know, like in my house, there's a power figure. I don't have to call the government and say, come and fix it. We have local electricians. And so how can we do that? So before ONganic, we had Switch-On, which was a not-for-profit, which until then, we were looking at that as an advocacy group doing climate awareness, etc. And we suddenly realized that there was a need because this was a not-for-profit activity, like you can't go start training entrepreneurs in rural areas. It doesn't make sense for a business to sort of do that. The costs can be very high and you're anyway struggling to, you know, break even. And so we sort of realized that there was this gap which Switch-On could come in and sort of start doing something about. So there was this time when Switch-On sort of started developing solar training programs and started training rural entrepreneurs in everything. Like even when they were marketing, they had to know how to size their systems. We had to have local electricians who could do it, who could help with installations, with servicing, etc. So yeah, that part of the story taken care of. We suddenly realized that we wanted to do more. So we were like, clean energy is not the end, it's the means to an end. So what else can you do with it? And agriculture was something that we were extremely passionate about. So we started to work in the solar irrigation space. I shared a lot about what we did before. But we went through this exact same journey in the solar irrigation space. And I think it's always where you crack a problem and there is another problem. But also what the space needs is a very hybrid approach where you can have some entities doing softer activities of ecosystem building, creating awareness. And you need entities who can, you know, deploy the technology, do the installations, provide the servicing. And it's very important for this ecosystem.
Thank you. I think clearly the sort of peripheral roles that have to be taken on by different enterprises, there's space, I think, for support in building these areas. I think clean sort of was mandated to do that starting in 2014. But then when you hear of the range of ways in which organizations are also trying to tackle it, Clearly, there's a lot more, I think, that we can do to support them. So I'd like to open it out to questions, because I know we're running a bit short on time. I'd like to, kind of get a few different questions, comments. Keep it very short, please. But if you have any one by one, I think we'll just maybe two questions at a time. We'll take it to the crowd and ask. Well, the roles that you mentioned, these are all sort of very, from what everyone was saying, very difficult to kind of crack. And so, if you were to, would you say that this was by necessity, or going forward, this is something that you would want to partner with someone to hive off? And if there was one part of that chain, which one would it be? Because these are sort of, all these activities are something being done by one entity. And I'm curious whether, did you do it because there was no one else doing it, and therefore you took on these roles? But if you were to hive off one bit, what would it be? Because what has been the cost of taking on so many roles as an enterprise?
In a way you are right, because this is something we took on very consciously in the model, the mini grid model, because we never wanted our mini grid model to be only access to clean electricity. Because we wanted our mini grid model to go beyond that and to impact local incomes, to impact village level GDP growth, and to build sustainable enterprises at the end of the day. So, but we had to prove it, because it's difficult. We are operating in a very difficult terrain, in that of Gumla district of Jharkhand, which is very underserved, unserved. So we just wanted to kind of showcase and prove that yes, it is possible. So we took on the various roles, that of a technology provider, that of a financier, that of doing the sales and marketing bit of it, and of course the community engagement part is there. So we took it on consciously to prove the model that it works. But finally, when we scale it up, we go forward, we really want to, as I said, outsource different components of this model, the first being the financing part. So that is, we first and foremost, we really want to do away with, but the process has been it's a build on kind of a thing. We have to work with the financiers, we have to work with the banks in order to sensitize them to the end user, the demands and the requirements on the ground. So this is something we have taken on right now, but of course, going forward, we would like to outsource some of the components.
Well, moving not very far from you, to Alicia. If I can, speak to Upendra G from Tarini
Enterprises. Upendra Sahoo, by the way.
So, so we definitely want you, to understand your story, sir. I know that you've been working for 20 years, I think, as an entrepreneur. But just recently got into being an energy entrepreneur, maybe in 2015. So I have Anukriti to sort of ask you whether, what has been your story, like what is the sort of energy business that you have done in Odisha, and what has been sort of, you're working in a tribal area, so what has been the challenges for that particular area that you've been working in?
इंस्टॉलेशन के बारे में कैसे लोगों को समझाने के बारे में, तो जब काम मैंने शुरू किया 2015 से पहला काम, तो मैं पहले मेरा चैलेंज ये था कि मैं लोगों के पास कैसे सोलर को पहुंचा। अगर मैं लोगों को के पास सोलर पहुंचा के सोलर मैंने बनूँ तो लोग उसके बाद मेरे पास आए, तो इसके लिए मुझे बहुत कुछ करना पड़ा। गाँव गाँव में मीटिंग करना पड़ा। हम लोग का 40 ब्लॉक है, 40 ब्लॉक में हम लोग सरपंच एक सरपंच करके पकड़ के मीटिंग पहले किया, तो उसके बाद कुछ पोस्टर बनाया, कुछ बैनर बनाया। तो आपका जो पॉपुलेशन एरिया है, जो इसे चौक एरिया है, आपका हाथों एरिया है, उसी एरिया में हम लोग वो बैनर का लगाया। तो उसके बाद हम सरपंच से लोन लेके 15 सिस्टम प्लस हमारे तरफ से 5 सिस्टम 10 गाँव में लगाया।
Work around 2015 full-fledged solar, and his main issue while starting was like, how should he reach out to the end user? What are the different ways that he can adopt to reach out to the end user? And one of the ways he adopted was to reach out to sarpanch of these 40 blocks and put out different advertising materials to reach out to the end users about his solar organization.
उसके बाद हम लोग को कुछ गांव वालों ने बुला के कुछ जब हम लोग उस गांव में 5 टू उस गांव में 10 टू ऐसे ऑर्डर भी आया हम लोग के पास तो उसके बाद जो और एक चैलेंज है उन लोगों को कैसे सोलर पहुंचा जाए तो उन लोग बहुत गरीब एरिया है गरीब एरिया में उन लोगों के पास पैसा नहीं कौन बोला हम 500 देंगे 1000 देंगे तो उसके बाद हम लोगों ने सेटल किया सेल्को से भी सेल्को से बात किया उन लोगों ने बैंकों को आश्वस्त किया कि 2-3 बार बैंकों का बैंक वालों ने भी ऐसे करके बहुत कमाने डिजर्व जिडर करके ऐसे फर्स्ट 10 टू विदाउट डिस्पोन में हम लोग को एक गांव को लगाने का अडॉप्ट किया था तो वो बड़कलाड़ी नाम का एक ग्राम पंचायत है उसी में पहले पारोटू एक पंडा नाम का एक बैंक मैनेजर था उन्होंने पहले विदाउट डिस्पोन लेके हमको पारो सिस्टम लगाने का अडॉप्ट किया था तो उसके बाद सोलर का डिमांड इसे इसे आस्ते आस्ते हो गया तो अभी हम लोग का बैंक की तरफ से 120 पीस बैंक की ऑर्डर से लगाया हो अभी भी बैंक में 60 पीस का सोलर दिया है तो इसे रिवोल्यूशन फंड के बारे में रिवोल्यूशन फंड और एक 2-3 एनजीओ के साथ काम करके करीबन हमने 600 होम लाइटिंग सिस्टम कम्प्लीट अभी तो किया है तो उसके बाद ऐसे अपने आप हम लोग को जो हम लोग होम लाइटिंग ये लाइवलीहुड का सिस्टम 2017 से स्टार्ट किया 2017 से सरत नाम का गांव है सरत आपका कत्तीपुरा ब्लॉक में सरत नाम का पंचायत है पंचायत का गांव है तो उनको लाइवलीहुड कैसे पहुंचा जाए तो हम एक दिन हमारा एक स्टाफ के साथ गया चलो उस दुकान में छोटा सा पान दुकान था जंगल का एरिया था पूरा जंगल इसी एरिया में हम एक LS के प्रोजेक्ट गए तो ठीक है उन लोग जाकर बोला तो यहाँ से जनक्स परस करते हो कितना डिस्टेंस है ना 15 किलोमीटर डिस्टेंस है तो यहाँ पकाने से कितना यहाँ तो लाइन नहीं है किसी जनक्स परस चलेगा तो हम चला देंगे उनको बोला बोला चला देंगे तो कितना कष्ट लगेगा हमें 1,20,000 करीबन लगेगा तो इतना पैसा तो हम नहीं दे सकते तो कितना दोगे 30-40 हज़ार दो नहीं 5-10 हज़ार देंगे तो बोला वो तो ये 5 वो भी लगाने के बाद 1 महीने के बाद बोला कि नहीं ठीक है तो हम लोग भी उनको से बात किया उन्होंने फर्स्ट हमको इसे क्या हो ठीक है करेंगे उनको जाके सर्वे करके देखा वो जगह चलेगा तो अभी वो जो LS के सेंटर है बहुत अच्छा चलता है विदाउट ये इलेक्ट्रिक से चलता है तो ऐसे हम लोग 6 LS के प्रोजेक्ट किया है तो अभी यही में इसमें ना फेब्रुआरी में हम लोग के ये प्रोजेक्ट देख के बैंक वालों को बुलाया पहले वजीर बैंक ने
initial issue was, as I think everybody had mentioned, was financing. People were ready to give like 500,000 rupees a month, but not as a lump sum amount. So as a solution, he said that let's mobilize bankers for it, and the initial bankers training was done. In that, I think a champion bankers was identified, and the initial 10 loans were done without risk guarantee. From that, his business picked up, and the more needs were identified. And eventually, he moved from home lighting system to livelihoods. The area that he works in is an extremely tribal area. The population is sparse. It's like very, very like segregated. So one of the key starts for his livelihood was, I think, a photocopier machine. The Lok Seva Kendra that we call it as. And he identified a petty shop in the middle of a village. And he asked him like, how far is the closest Photoshop that you have access to? And people said like 15 to 20 kilometers is the closest one. So he said, why don't you adopt this as a solution with your petty shop? He said, but we don't have grid connection. He said, we've got it. But I think the cost was like 1,20,000 of whole system because there was nothing. So photocopier machine with a solar solution. And I think they were negotiating with the end user, and he said, "Acha, how much will you give?" And they said, "We'll give. Can you give 40,000? No, we can give 10,000. And then finally, it was put. Initially, it was put up a demo system, and then they converted into a sale. And from now, he has done like 6 such systems in these villages, which are very far off, providing access to Lok Seva Kendra and the e-services to the end users. And
अभी बैंक वालों ने वो सेंटर देख के तीन बैंक बैंक एक आपका ओजीबी ओडिशा ग्रामीण बैंक सिंडिकेट बैंक यूनाइटेड बैंक तीन बैंक वालों को हम वो जो एलएसके का दिखाया था एलएसके का ब्लर वाइज हमको दिखाया ब्लर जो क्या ब्लर तीन को ब्लर हमने किया दिखाया था और देखते तो पहले ओजी वालों ने बोला दे देंगे छः डॉक्यूमेंट्स लेकर उनको दिया नहीं किया उन्होंने नहीं किया तो उसके बाद सिंडिकेट ब्रांच में सिंडिकेट ब्रांच हम लोग का उपला का ब्रांच और पुराडिया का ब्रांच तो दो दो ब्रांच में दो टू पहले किया है फरवरी महीना में किया है एक बैंक ने डिस्काउंट लेके किया एक बैंक ने विदाउट डिस्काउंट में लेकिन बैंक वाला ने बोला कि क्यों डिस्काउंट ले ना हम लोग का पहला कस्टमर है तो सिक्स मंथ अगर उनका अकाउंट होता तो हम डिस्काउंट नहीं ले तो उसके बाद हम जो एक ब्लोअर के पास गए तो ब्लोअर वाला ने इसे साइकिल चक्का घुमा के काम कर रहे थे तो मैं बोला क्यों भाई तुम साइकिल चक्का तो आपको एक मशीन देंगे आपका पूरा काम होगा बोला हाँ कितना आपका दिल्ली जाता है ना हम लोग का 250 रुपया मुजरी जाता है बोलते हैं 250 रुपया हम लोग खाना करना पड़ता है तो कब आता है कब नहीं आता है तो अभी इसे करके चलाता है तो ये भी सड़क पंचायत में छोटा एरिया है तो कॉमर्स वाले उसी में हम एक आदिवासी लोग हैं और उनको जाके ठीक है तो उनको देखे एक ब्रोशर दे गया तो उनको भी अच्छा लगा ब्रोशर वो भी पैसा 2000 पहले दिया था ऐसे करके ऐसा ऐसा करके कुछ कुछ देते हैं तो अभी हमारे पास वो तीन ब्लॉर ऐसे काम हुआ है अभी हमारे पास एक प्रोजेक्ट यह है 100 ब्लॉर को एक ढोकरा प्रोजेक्ट है ढोकरा प्रोजेक्ट में उनका पूरा गांव इसे काम करता है उनका स्वयं का ब्लॉर का जो करते सब इसे हाथ के मशीन से घुरा के काम करते उनको प्रोजेक्ट कैसे होगा किसके तरफ होगा वो बातचीत चल रहा है तो देखे
He was able to mobilize funds for his LSK through two banks, one with without risk guarantee and one with risk guarantee. That is like one model that he has explored. And the other thing that he is saying that how he is convincing the end users to adopt sustainable energy solutions is that he shows them as like as everybody said like demos as one of the important mediums to showcase the technology to the end user. And with this, he has identified a place with Dogra craft. It's a metal casting craft in which there's a village of 100 end users. Now he's working on that project to mobilize financing for these 100 end users for blacksmith blowers.
So, sir, if I can ask you, of all the things that you mentioned, it seemed that finance, what is the most difficult for you in?
Most difficult for financing. तो बैंक वालों ने इसे मैनेजर बोल देते हैं तो फाइनेंस कर देंगे फील्ड ऑप्शन नहीं देंगे और मैं वो जी भी क्यों बोला मैं देखिए तो मैं वो आपका कस्टमर है जो जो एलएसके दिया है एलएसके का कस्टमर वो जी भी का है सिंडिकेट का कस्टमर नहीं है सिंडिकेट ने उनको उनका अकाउंट भी नहीं था सिंडिकेट ने फाइनेंस किया वो जी भी तो फाइनेंस नहीं किया तो प्रॉब्लम होता है ओनली बैंक का नहीं तो लोगों अगर सोलर एक लोगों को ऐसे दिमाग में भी है सोलर एक ले जाने से क्या पूरा करंट आएगा उनको भी समझाना पड़ता है अगर वो समझ जाए तो सोलर क्या चीज है वो सोलर पे नहीं चलेगा इलेक्ट्रिक छोड़ देगा तो हम कुछ इस घर में भी ऐसे होम लाइटिंग लगाए दो तीन लाइट एक छोटा सा फैन लगाए तो उनको तो हमारा लाइन ठीक है लाइन तुम ये दो रूम में दो बल्ब को बंद कर दो करीबन महीना में 100 रुपया तो बचेगा आपका इसे कुछ घर को हम समझा के दिया है तो दो घर रूम में दो लाइन लगा दो तुम्हारा लाइन था कोई भी रिमोनेशन फोन के बारे में इस काम हुआ था गाँव में तुम दो लाइन बंद कर दो पूरा पूरा टोटल ऑफ कर दो लाइन खोल दो अब दो लाइन खरीदेंगे तो 100-100 उसको बिल भी देंगे 40 रुपया आएगा महीने की 50 रुपया आएगा उसको तो बंद हो जाएगा ना इसे करके लोगों को कुछ समझाना पड़ता है और मेन क्रिटिकल है बैंक फाइनेंशियल बैंक वाला देंगे नहीं वो बोलेंगे हम सब एक बैंक में सब प्रोजेक्ट दिया है सार वालों ने भी गया था हमारे साथ एक बैंक में सब प्रोजेक्ट दिया है उनका सामने सार वालों के सामने ही उनको जा सर हम प्रोजेक्ट दिया आप क्यों नहीं देंगे ना हमारा मर्जी जब होगा हम देंगे सर बोलो पूरा हमारा मर्जी 70 प्रोजेक्ट दिया है 10 प्रोजेक्ट दिया है कैसे जी ग्रुप का दिया ये कैसे जी ग्रुप का क्यों दिया वो तो गुस्सा से जी ग्रुप को लेने वाले अब देंगे देंगे
So he's saying that it doesn't matter if the banker says yes, ultimately when they go on the field officer sometimes says no. So he has faced continuous issues with availing finance through banks, and it has times happened that he has taken the end user of one bank and told the bank that this is your end user only, he has an account in your bank, why aren't you giving him the loan? The bank hasn't given the loan, whereas the bank where the end user doesn't have an account, the other bank has given the loan. So for him, there is no particular calculation of which bank will give, which will not give. He doesn't know because there are various factors. So he is saying that we have gone with SELCO team various times to banks, and we have asked them that these are your SHGs, why aren't you giving the loans? And the bank managers have told, it is our wish, we'll give whenever we want to give or whenever we have time. So that has been an issue. And then he's also talking about his this thing about how to mobilize end user for adopting solutions where the basic the grid is already there. So he has right now done a 50 home lighting solution with one of the NGOs as a partner, and we have done it through the revolving fund model. But there, at some of the parts, the grid was there, but how did he actually influence the end user to adopt this sustainable energy solution? It's like he goes there and he tells them that you remove these two bulbs, you remove it, then you will see the impact on your electricity bill. Put solar, and then we'll see it for a month and see how it goes.
सर एक बैंक वालों को मैं 15 दिन पहले मैं पत्तूदा ब्रांच ओजीबी ब्रांच में गया था फैक्ट्री हाउस में उसको जेल में उन्होंने बोला हम दे देंगे तो ठीक है सर दे देंगे तुम चल चल नहीं नहीं ऐसे नहीं देंगे और सर कैसे देंगे ना बोला कि फैक्ट्री हाउस का लोन आपका नाम में कर देता हूँ आप उसको दे दीजिए पेमेंट हमको महीना का दे दीजिए हमको चिट्ठी कर दिया सर्को को से चिट्ठी कर दिया सर्को से मिल गया हम लोग हमारी तरफ से उनको रिकवर करके 35 सिस्टम रिकवर अभी दो सिस्टम बाकी है हर दिन मैनेजर हमको दो लोगों ने दिया नहीं फॉकिंग मैनेजर को पता वो लोग जो दो लोग बाकी रहा आपका दिया नहीं सलाह कर रहे अरे भाई तुम लोग को इंटरेस्ट लोगे हम क्या करेंगे तो टोटली उनको जो मैनेजर को इंटरेस्ट नहीं लेता निकलने में वो उनको क्या होता है कि अगर वो सलाह लोग घर में लगाए तो उनका कोई सैलरी नहीं बढ़ेगा कि नहीं लगाए तो नहीं सैलरी बढ़ेगा तो उनका क्यों इंटरेस्ट देते थे और बोला कि तुम 2-3 लाख का प्रोजेक्ट ला हम दे दें ये छोटा मोटा प्रोजेक्ट लेने के लिए तो भी मैं बहुत कोशिश करके 3-4 बैंक में 110 करीबन प्रोजेक्ट किया है और भी 30-40 प्रोजेक्ट मैंने एसएचजी तो लास्ट टाइम फाइनल हुआ आरएम के साथ एसएचजी ग्रुप माध्यम से देने एसएचजी ग्रुप माध्यम से 4 एसएचजी ग्रुप दिया है और 3 दे और एलएस के तो अभी दिया है वो पेमेंट भी उसमें अभी वो जो डैम बंदा लिया था पेमेंट भी दे दिया और वो भी एलएस के सिंडिकेट दे तो सब मैनेजर का ऊपर निर्भर करता है लोन तो वो देंगे नहीं देंगे ऊपर उनका अपन मर्जी तो बोला कि हम प्रोजेक्ट सब सतो देते हैं दो देते हैं इसे हम करेंगे करेंगे बोलेंगे तो बोल मना नहीं करेंगे सर मना नहीं भी मैडम वालों किया था उन्होंने ब्रांच को क्या हुआ कैसे तकलीफ होता है
That's one more story from the ground that he's sharing. He's saying that he went to the bank manager for 30 household loans, and he's like, so bank manager is like, okay, we'll give the loan. So he's like, come, let's go on the field for the loan. He's like, no, I give it to you. You take the liability and then you give it to them. So he's saying, like an entrepreneur, the managers are expecting the entrepreneur to take on the liability for the repayment of the loan. He has one of the cases where they have done 40 loans to the bank, and 30 of the loans went through NPA. So the bank manager called SELCO, bank manager called him, and the team went on the ground and did the recovery, but there were still two people who had not repaid. So there were constant calls to the entrepreneurs, like, why the repayment is not happening. So he's saying that that's the bank's role also to do it, because they are the ones who are taking the interest for the recollection, for providing the services to the end users. That is their role, to provide the accessible finance for the end users in the rural areas. So, but when they go for loans, the liability comes on their head for the collection, for finding out the correct end users to do the paperwork. So that is not something that he's able to understand. But in spite of all this, he is able to mobilize loans, and which is like commendable, from 3 to 4 banks. And he's saying that I've done 110 loans from banks, and he's also expecting another 40-50 in the coming time.
So I think, thank you, Upendra. I think that was a nice way to articulate it. So I think the resilience of knowing that, yes, even though financing is a barrier, I think if I ask everyone which is a barrier, I suppose that would be the number one thing. But I think sort of understanding that there is a demand, there is a clear demand, but sort of the one of the, I would say the criticisms that you hear is, oh, it's not scaling fast, or it's not moving fast enough. But I think part of the issue is that also the number of roles that an enterprise has to take on, if he did not have to chase after this financing, maybe it could have been a different story. And I think that's part of the challenge to all of us in this room. You know, how do you make some of those things easier? So it doesn't fall on the enterprise to be able to do it. I think somewhere, I think there's an expectation that they will do everything, or all these systems are already in place. But that doesn't seem to be the case clearly from Upendraji's, you know, sort of stories. But so moving on, I mean, again, to the eastern part of India still, and it's with our final panelist, Ekta from ONganic. Clearly, again, an organization, ONganic, but 2-3 arms of organizations. Maybe you can speak to any preferred. Everybody speak. I think there's obviously an energy enterprise, but you've also there were different entities that started to take on different roles at different points. Maybe you can speak to that a little bit, because I know that there was something with skilling there, and then there was something with market linkages. So maybe you can also speak to, I think, why you had to take on those different roles, different entities that had to be created as part of the energy.
Sure. So one very interesting thing that we have sort of realized over the years is that when you enter the space of social entrepreneurship or, you know, rural development, and I think we also got this through the day, you're not there to sell a product, you're not there to do a project, you're there to find a solution to a problem that bothers you. And I think everyone in this space sort of goes with that drive and passion that we want to find an answer, you know, how can you make this work? And so every time you start with the first problem. So when we sort of decided that we wanted to work in the clean energy space, the first problem that we sort of faced was in West Bengal, people were not really aware about clean energy. So we thought that was a big problem. So we did a lot of this awareness programs and this creative outreach, etc. So once we sort of crossed that first barrier and sort of people got excited about solar and sort of they said, yeah, we want to buy solar. And we, at that point, we were sort of very new in this space, we were promoting solar lights. And we suddenly realized that people were not interested in lights. So they, to real people, they wanted something much larger, like they've seen lights in the homes, like, you know, TVs and fans. And so they were like, we already have a kerosene lamp, so can we have something larger? And also, I think they had also seen in neighboring villages, you know, through government programs. So they said, no, we don't want this, we want larger home systems. So you go with an idea thinking that this is an affordable solution, but it's not aspiring enough. And so you go back and then you design a larger home system. And then you're like, now I have the solution. You know, this is what they want. And then you take it back to them. And then they're like, this is too expensive. We can't buy this. This is very expensive. And I think it was around the same time also that we got incubated by SELCO. And so this whole financing piece sort of fell into place. And initially, like some of these organizations, we did some financing ourselves. We realized that it was not a space that we really wanted to be in. And so then we got some bank financing happening. Once that challenge, it's never cracked enough, but once you sort of feel like you have cracked it, you suddenly realize that you're working in extreme remote areas, and you know your centers are about 3-4 hours away, and your customers are like rivers and, you know, whatever away. And when there is a breakdown, servicing becomes a big challenge. You have to send people that far, and then, you know, what do you do? And so this is around that time that, so when we sort of realized that it's very important to have these local ecosystem built, where, you know, like in my house, there's a power failure. I don't have to call the government and say, come and fix it. We have local electricians. And so how can we do that? So
Before ONG, we had Switch On, which was a not-for-profit, which until then we were looking at that as an advocacy group doing climate awareness, etc. And we suddenly realized that there was a need for because this was a not-for-profit activity. Like, you can't go start training entrepreneurs in rural areas. It doesn't make sense for a business to sort of do that. The costs can be very high, and you're anyway struggling to, you know, break even. And so we sort of realized that there was this gap which Switch On could come in and sort of start doing something about. So there was this time when Switch On sort of started developing solar training programs and started training rural entrepreneurs in everything. Like, even when they were marketing, they had to know how to size their systems. We had to have local electricians who could help with installations, servicing, etc. So yeah, that part of the story taken care of. We suddenly realized that we wanted to do more. So we were like, clean energy is not the end, it's the means to an end. So what else can you do with it? And agriculture was something that we were extremely passionate about. So we started to work in the solar irrigation space. I shared a lot about what we did before. We went through this exact same journey in the solar irrigation space. And I think it's always that you crack a problem and there is another problem. But also what this space needs is a very hybrid approach where you can have some entities doing software activities of ecosystem building, creating awareness. And you need entities who can, you know, deploy the technology, do the installations, provide the servicing. And it's very important for this ecosystem. Thank you. I think clearly the sort of peripheral roles that have to be taken on by different enterprises, there's space, I think, for support in building these areas. I think Clean sort of was mandated to do that starting in 2014. But then when you hear of ways in which organizations are also trying to tackle it, clearly there's a lot more, I think, that we can do to support them. So I'd like to open it out to questions, because I know we're running a bit short on time. I'd like to, you know, kind of get a few different questions, comments. Keep it very short, please. But if you have any one by one, I think we'll just maybe two questions at a time. We'll take it to the crowd and ask you.
From Tanzania, I represent a solar company called SELCO. My question is to Ekta. How were you able to combine like the energy part of it, and then the agriculture part of it, and then the financing in between those two? Thanks.
I'll come in here because it's really Maharashtra. I just want to know a little more about the revolving loans systems and then how they are offered to the groups or individuals. A little bit more technical details about the revolving loan fund. Because there was a reference by three of them, so.
In the agriculture space, we wanted to sort of see where can clean energy play a significant role and where are these energy gaps in the agriculture ecosystem. Very clearly, so I think a lot of people have spoken about it. Our previous session was on solar irrigation. And irrigation was an area which was, there is a stark need for, because a lot of these farms are in off-grid areas or areas where there is no grid accessibility available so easily. People use a lot of diesel. So one easy way to identify is where is it that people are using diesel for doing some sort of an agriculture activity. And I think that's a great spot to start working on, because you know there is a market, because it's paying a very high price for diesel. And if they can switch to solar there, then it sort of starts to make economic sense plus a lot of other sense for a lot of other reasons. So some of these areas, irrigation was one of the first areas that we started to work in. We set up demos very similar to what we set up demos. We started to collection ourselves, realized that there was a very high potential. Then started to work with banks, set up an FLDG, created GLGs, and through these GLGs, there was one person who was elected as
a GLG is like a joint viability group.
And there was a water entrepreneur who was providing water as a service, collecting money, paying VMIs. and also making some money. So that was one model that we started working on. There was another model that we started working on, was around solar cooling. So these were different areas that we started working in. And I think the potential, especially what we saw today, and the kind of solutions that are available in the agriculture space, I'm so excited. So I know that, and I now work very strongly in the agriculture space. I'm an organic company. I work with so many groups across West Bengal. I know some of them would love to take up some of these solutions that we discussed today. So I think it's just, there's a lot of potential in the agriculture space in Kerala. Yes.
Hi, my name is
agriculture. सोलर एग्रीकल्चर फाइनेंसिंग हम लोग का इंडिया में उड़ीसा में उसको बैंक के साथ लिंक हो सकता है. हम लोग एक किया है वो आपका बैंक में आपका दो एकड़ जमीन होना चाहिए. आपको सोलर पंप मिलेगा, सोलर पैनल होगा, उनके बैंक फाइनेंस देगा आपको 40% सब्सिडी मिलेगा नाबार्ड के तरफ से. वो स्कीम अभी भी है, हम लोग एक स्कीम किया है. तो ऐसे सिस्टम से एग्रीकल्चर पर्पस में नाबार्ड की तरफ से ऐसे स्कीम है अभी चल रहा है.
There is a scheme by Government of India in which the bank provides loans for irrigation services, especially for pumps, in which the 40% subsidy is given for people who are having 2 acres of land. So he has availed that service and reached out to bank and has got one loan for his end user.
रिगोलिंग फंड के बारे में, तो रिगोलिंग फंड हम सेल्को की एक एनजीओ आरंभ हुआ, जो हमारा लोकल एनजीओ है उनके साथ. जब हम लोगों ने बैंक में बहुत डिफिकल्ट हुआ, लोगों ने सोलर लोगों के घर में नहीं पहुंचा सका, तो रिगोलिंग फंड से हम लोग एक सिस्टम डिजाइन किया है जो 13,500 रुपये में आपका 2 बल्ब देते हैं, एक फैन पंखा देते हैं, उनको पूरा इंस्टॉल करके लोगों के घरों तक पहुँचाते हैं. इंस्टॉल भी आपका पूरा पाइप वगैरह देखे, ऑर्डर देखे, पूरा एकदम क्वालिटी इंस्टॉल होता है. और रिगोलिंग फंड लोगों ने किस्ती किस्ती करके देते हैं, वो एन जी ओ को देते हैं. हम लोग का काम है हम लोग उनको घर में इंस्टॉल करें, और इंटरेस्ट कुछ होता है वो एन जी ओ की तरफ से प्रॉब्लम होता है उनका कितना इंटरेस्ट.
My question is to Mr. Joysing. My name is Raghav Agarwal and I represent a company called Rotomap. We are the manufacturer of solar water pumps. I am aware of your Karbi and Long area fully. I work in Hojai, Olaghat, Nogaon, etc. And many people would know that Karbi and Long is a plateau which is even bigger than Meghalaya state altogether. So my question to you is, how do you do irrigation? Because you do not get funding for irrigation from the state government. You are an autonomous council. And how do you propose to take the irrigation forward, because the land holding is so small there? So do you have a plan, and do you plead for what kind of support you would be looking for?
So right now we are not planning for irrigation. It's a hilly area.
Yes.
Yeah. So irrigation is difficult for that area. So right now I am focused only for room lighting system and livelihood system in Kalbiangan area, especially for room lighting system. Because in the hilly area, remote area, like a plateau, hillock, like a hillock system in Kalbiangan. And in road condition it's not good, so it's difficult to get water from the tube well to get in that area.
This is where you can start thinking, because Meghalaya started thinking for Garo, where is Khasi. Now for the Karbi tribe, you can have special funding. I'm sure SELCO Foundation can possibly sort of anchor that type of it, and the water can be pumped from as much as 500 feet below the ground today. Their technology exists and it is being done in several parts of the country. I have seen very small fields, people are growing vegetables, etc.
Yes.
I suppose at some point it becomes entry point interventions that can happen that are probably easier to crack first and then moving on to maybe a little bit more challenging or difficult ones. Any other questions for the panel? Yes, sir.
Hi, my name is Harsh. I'm from Customized Energy Solutions. I have a question for Sudeshna. And my question is, is the current mini-grid model, like business model, already bankable? Can it attract funds, or do you think any more interventions are required?
That is in Jharkhand, Gumla. So from a bankability point of view, in terms of if you think of a break-even, so what the targets that we have set for ourselves, we are looking at a 7 years kind of a break even on the capex and the opex, the business model. So to achieve that, so we have set utilization targets for ourselves. That is why I mentioned that this livelihood, sustainable livelihood solutions go a long way in ensuring that we reach our utilization targets and revenue realizations to achieve that break even. So yes, I won't say that at this point of time that it's already the model is bankable enough, but yes, we are on track. It's a work in progress, and with the growth of this productive loads in our operational mini-grid villages in Jharkhand, and scaling up of such a last mile livelihood solutions, we are sure to reach there.
Time for one more question, if there is. Any questions?
Always has to be a policy question.
No, but this is not actually the policy question. So this is building upon the very last point we were discussing around the MLinda model. So Sudeshna, you mentioned that utilization of the mini grid is something which is a critical factor for you to look at the break even, right? I'm not sure how the sort of organization is currently structured, but best panels, there are two parallel verticals that we have. One is the energy side of things, and then the entire market linkages and other bits that are happening. So now it's a bit of a dichotomy here, right? As a mini-grid company, you want higher utilization, which means that you probably do not want energy efficiency of the end appliance, which you're putting for livelihood, right? Because if you put more energy efficient appliance, your utilization of the mini-grid will come down. So how you as an organization is doing both sides of the story, trying to tackle this solution? What's the classic problem of what utilities do not want energy efficient solution and so on? But in the renewable space, I have actually always seen energy efficiency promoting renewables. But in this case, if you're looking at two different data sheets, one is of mini-grid or micro-grid, and another is for, let's say, a not-for-profit doing the market linkages, how do you sort of square the problem of energy efficiency?
A good question, Abhishek. So my take is a little different. My take is that you're right in a way, because it affects my utilization at the end of the day if I use or promote energy efficiency in my the grids. But the take is that if the consumers benefit at the end of the day, right? So once the consumers they benefit, then the volumes, now they have they are using X number of energy efficient devices. But when they see that they benefit in terms of cost optimization, less utilization of electricity for the same device with a greater output, then the volumes will go up. I feel it will be X plus 10, X plus 20%, so that volume will, initially there will be a dip, no doubt. There will be a dip initially, but that dip again will grow and start climbing with the increase of volumes in the energy efficient devices. So no doubt about it, initially there will be a dip, and it's bound to affect the economics of the model. But if we see long term, it's bound to benefit the customers as well as the mini-grid provider. So there will be a kind of a compatibility between the two.
All right. Well, thank you very much. I think that was, we ended the last question, but, thank you very much for your patience and to my panelists, I think for very well articulating, and I think, more in a story form, sort of telling all of us what, are some of the various roles or hats that they have to take on. If you look at all the roles, I think the criticism that how can we scale, why are things scaling faster, I think
if you listen very carefully to what all they're saying, it's that one particular entity is tasked with doing a lot of things. And various partners who have to play their role don't end up playing that role. And I think the challenge in this room, and I think this is an audience where you have policy people, you have enterprises, you have end users, you have enterprises, you have a various a group set impact firms, so you have a various diverse set of stakeholders. I think if we are not able to solve this problem, or if we find ways to correct some of these things, I think next year we'll be hearing a lot of the same thing. There's obviously a learning curve, and there's a long time, some of these gestation period that some of these things take. But I'd like to leave that thought by saying that I think it's quite a resilient group of folks, I think, who continue this. And hopefully we'll all continue to play our role in breaking some of these barriers for them. So with that, I'd like to thank the panel and close the session for the day. And I'll have Angel come in and maybe give a token of appreciation here to all our panelists. It's more like a suitcase for the Moderator.